Good. Welcome to a new session of Reinforce the Horse podcast.
And welcome.
Glad you're here.
Yep.
Glad your cat is here.
Yep.
He seems really happy this morning.
Yeah.
So I thought this morning we'd talk about this idea of pause to perform. And so not long ago, I heard in a couple different places talking about, I guess, like an old school method that cowboys used in training horses called dwell time. And it's such that, like, you teach them something and then you just kind of let them be for a while. And then when you think you've let them be for too long, you let them be longer. And I think they talked about this in the evidence-based horsemanship book, because what's going on with their brain and even our brain, like when we learn something, our subconscious kind of takes that information and dwells upon it and basically reinforces that.
That's very interesting. I mean, I know with using the positive reinforcement methods, it's good to let them even think about what they've learned then. I mean, you do it for like 15, 20 minutes, and then you leave the pen and let them do whatever they do. And then you come back, maybe work on the same things for like 3-4 days in a row before moving on and letting them have their breaks.
Yeah.
So they can think about it.
And so scientifically, evidently, this is actually a science-based thing. And how the brain actually goes through and processes new information and ultimately growing new neural pathways. Hmm. So my question for you is, have you seen this sort of playing out with Willow and Cody recently?
Yeah. I mean, well, especially being able to give them their choice, but as well as, you know, just kind of letting them be and not asking anything of them and not expecting anything from them. We just kind of like let them be, and it's, I found that they want to be with us more, which is really cool.
Yeah. I've also found specifically, we've been doing a lot of work with the trailer and getting both of the horses comfortable with the trailer, and it's been as simple as just leaving it open for them having that choice to go up to it. And it's on our walking paths. The trailer is parked on our walking path, well, to the side of our walking path, such that when we start a walk, we walk right past the trailer. And now Willow and Cody both are starting to go over to the trailer, even if the doors are closed, and they'll target it with their nose. They'll sniff around. They'll rub it with their vibrissae, which, by the way, the vibrissae, am I saying that right?
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah. Is the little
hairs on the
whiskers.
Bottom.
We would call them whiskers. They're not really whiskers. They are actually sensory organs.
Yeah.
And they actually have, the way I understand it, their own nerve endings associated with them. So very sensitive hairs on their face and muzzle and such that they use to get more in tune with their environment. And so they'll go over to the trailer and do that, and it's pretty awesome to just watch them kind of reenact what went on before in their brain, and then think about, okay, how can I do something essentially to get reinforced? And I'm finding that reinforcement doesn't always need to be a treat. I'm reinforcing a lot just with my mindset.
Yeah.
So
present momenting.
Yeah. But even to the extent of, you know, coming into that present moment, but then just thinking, good job or well done or thank you. And just by having those thoughts, I believe like my energy shifts a bit, and they sense that and they feel good about it.
They like it. They like to do good.
So what I'm learning is the more I pause, the better they are at performing.
And the more they want to perform.
Yeah.
Which is really cool.
It's fun to see and, like, just begin to understand that. Like, yesterday was a really good example. So I was the only one home, and I was doing some work on the house and just finishing some window frames and such. And, like, Cody and Willow were out, and Cody just came up to me. Willow wasn't more than 50 feet away. And he just came up and stood there. Not, hey, give me a treat, or hey, do this, or nothing. He was just 100% feeling good about being right next to me.
That's cool.
Yeah. And so that goes into that pausing sort of idea. Like, I think a lot of people, from what I've seen anyways, or heard, a lot of people are really hell-bent on training.
Yeah.
Like, hours upon hours a day. And that might be okay, but I would say, like, let's go back to some of the old cowboy ideas of just extending some dwell time for them.
And letting them just take the time to think about what they've learned. I mean, I know, like, weekends for school are really nice because it allows me time to just kind of think about what I've learned in the past week.
Oh, yeah.
And so I can kind of relate it to that. I mean, with training Willow, she was a blank slate. I mean, coming from the wild, and I taught her virtually everything she knows now. And hours upon hours of her just having that time to think about what she's done. And what she's done right, and what she could improve on, and then coming back, you know, an hour, 2 hours later to work with her again, she's like, she performs better than she did the first time, and then she seems more in tune, like she enjoys it more.
And this also, to me, ties into the idea of getting their environment as close to nature as possible, and. Of course, I mean, right now we have what I would consider pretty small pens. They're not stalls, but, you know, they're not free ranging right now, but we're more and more letting them free range throughout the day.
Yeah.
And, like, right now they're out and about just walking around. And to me, that's dwell time. That's pausing as well, because they're not in a work situation. They're able to mosey around and graze, which horses love to do. And they're willing to be a herd, even if it's just the two of them. And just sitting and watching them and observing their herd mentality, even just between the two of them, is really amazing to watch. And, like, to start to see their patterns. I know... right now I'm going through Carolyn Resnick's book, Naked Liberty, which is fantastic. And she talks about that, how, you know, in her young years, she observed the wild horses and just that rhythm and flow that they had. And she likens it, like, it's similar to schools of fish and stuff like that, and dolphins, and you know, just to watch them and see how they maneuver when they're in their sort of relaxation time. It's really neat to see play out.
Yeah. And it's really kind of cool because, like, when one of them will venture off, the other, I mean, usually, like, Cody will walk somewhere and then Willow will, like, keep grazing. But if he gets too far, like, they have a distance that they'll just, like, they'll run back to each other. And they'll talk, like, they talk telepathically. Like, Cody will be like, all right, too far. How about you come see me now? Willow will be like, all right, be right there. She'll make her way over. It's really cool.
So I feel like all these things are, like, really important just to provide balance for them. And because even us. I mean, we ask a lot of them in the way of like learning, and we're teaching them new things all the time. And just being able to throttle our expectations back and allowing them to have the time to contemplate the new ideas that they've been taught. To me, it just seems to be accelerating the training process.
Yeah. And I feel like it allows them to want to be in that training setting even more. Like, you use the trailer as an example. Like, we'll just be going on a walk and they'll both be like, oh, the trailer, it seems nice. We should go and work with the trailer.
It's almost like, well, I thought about that last night and it was good, so let's do it again.
Seriously.
That's kind of what it feels like.
Or, I mean, like the mounting block, for example. I guess using a tire as of right now, one of those big, like, tractor tires. And both of the horses, I mean, we were working with them on, I guess, just being comfortable with us around or on, like, above their level. Sorry, we're being swarmed by puppies here.
We got dogs and cats and all kinds of animals just enjoying our company right now.
But yeah, I mean, Willow stood at the mounting block for like 10 minutes after I had released her and told her, like, you know, you don't have to be at the mounting block anymore. And Cody, I mean, they've been sniffing it all morning, just kind of making sure that I'm not over there reinforcing them for being there, which is kind of cool.
Yeah. So any other ideas or thoughts on the idea of pausing to perform or pause to perform?
I think it's good for not only horses, but us humans and dogs and, I mean, really anything that's learning. I mean, this is Suds here. He's a puppy and he's learning something new every day. And, I mean, giving him the chance to run around and, you know, be a puppy for a little while is also good for him. I bet, I mean, when we go back to training, he will perform a lot better.
Yeah.
Likewise with the horses and me, because I'm in school and I like to chillax on the weekends. And
I found it really interesting that this goes back to sort of like the cowboy up style of training when it comes to horses.
Yeah.
You know, like, you know, when I think of like the rugged, harsh cowboy, I don't really think of them being like let's give the horses dwell time.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I mean, now there's like 100-day Mustang makeovers and tip training and, I mean, all sorts of competitions that like you have 3 months to train a horse or you have 100 days to train a horse. And it's like this horse has zero dwell time.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, perhaps in those situations, it's like a really
small amount,
large level of activity. But then maybe those trainers are giving them special opportunity throughout the evening and night or whatever their schedule is to, you know, provide that pause. That's it's a good question because I don't like to get pigeonholed in the idea of that, like, compressing a time frame or something like that is inherently bad.
Yeah.
Maybe more so that it just requires more thought in how the time actually plays out because, you know, we all have 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Yeah. That's a good point. I like that. Athena here is enjoying sitting here.
Well, I think that's all I got for this one.
Yeah, I think so.
Pretty quick. Just a thought.
Dwell time.
Yeah, just a thought of dwell time. I think I'm going to go take my dwell time.
Yeah, seriously.
Have a good day, guys.
Bye.